I said good day, sir!
Welcome back, everybody, here to your defense coverage powered by Razor as well as BenQ for this going to be flawless third game. Bottom going up against the boys from, I believe, Russia, Team Empire. Led by Blow Your Brain. We're jumping inside the game right now and I'm going to give vocals over to my co-commentator as well. He's also our admin for this evening. So the guy is multitasking unlike multiple men around the world. His name is Ham Sandwich. How you doing, man?
I'm doing well. Currently, I still have my own issues with multitasking, though. I almost started the game all-pick.
that would have been fun. That would have been fun.
But we caught it in time, and it is captain's mode.
We now have the new way of going through our draft. We're going to completely obliterate the draft, and all third games will be decided by an all-pick mode. Fantastic. I love
it. Whoever can lock, like, and first.
Yeah. I don't know how fast your computer loads to click on that. But we can look at this game right now. So PB and Empire, they remain on the same side. So Empire remain on the Radiant side. Bottom will remain on the Dire side. And they will duke it out from here. The winner gets to advance. The loser gets to go home. Well, they are probably home, but they will just not advance in the lower bracket of the defense. To see who they play up against, you'll need to watch tomorrow. We've got some huge-ass games coming out tomorrow. I really don't know how we're going to survive tomorrow, man. Mouse Moscow 5, MTW CLG, and Quantic and Na'Vi. The games, two of these games were also delayed.
I don't even know. Like, you can't call any of those matches. I mean, you might be able to say that Na'Vi is the favorite against Quantic, but you can't count Quantic out. I mean, they went 5-0 in their group.
Mm-hmm. Quantic have been pretty good, and with their new lineup, maybe it's going to work 100% for them. But yeah, Na'Vi is a team which can definitely test. They've got themselves a little bit of an unlucky draw. You could say as far as the groups go, but hey, it could work for them. We could have ourselves another upset loss, or Na'Vi could be just stronger than ever, and then we have to face up against a horrible reality of Quantic being in the bottom bracket. But yeah, that's all coming up tomorrow. For now, we have today. We've got Empire vs. PB. Now, note, we will be sticking with PB going into the next game up against Virtus Pro. We will be doing that game next, and then the grand final of the Fnatic RC Raid Call is what that stands for, Cup. So we're going to be broadcasting that one out. Then Guild Wars! Then Guild Wars 2. With your chance to win Guild Wars keys as well. I'm going to give Guild Wars keys out during the live stream. So people can come and either join me or, they can get access to the game and have themselves a little bit of fun. I believe I'm also going to see if I can coerce Sing Sing to come and join me for that one as well.
I heard that he said yes so long as he doesn't have any mouse sports commitments.
Yes, that was what he told me. So I'm like, you know what, I'll go with that. That's decent enough.
Just hope that he doesn't like, guys, we need to practice.
It's like, screw practicing, man, there's Guild Wars 2 to play. We've got PB now. What do we got for their lineup? It's strong again from them. Aoi gets his Morphling back again, Fog gets his Invoker, and they're going to combine it with an SD. So this is possibility to gank anywhere on the map at any point. That Exhort Invoker, we saw Exhort Quas from Fog in the last game. Got that Sunstrike up really early on, was on the mark almost 100% with every single Sunstrike. And then you're going to add an SD setup with that one too. So bottom, they're going to look pretty strong with just these first three pickups. Empire, however, they got a good jungler, in fact, one of the best ones. They're going to go max up on the team fight, and they're going to take Latrak as well. So we've got tower pushing, we've got counter pushing, and we've got team fight from Empire. So perfect lineup for the way Empire likes to play, and a perfect lineup for the way PB likes to play.
And now it's just going to be a question of who can execute their style the best. This is for all the marbles. I guess the winner of this plays up against Darrer.
Yes.
If what Holy Master has told me is truthful and
launches website right now,
10 seconds remaining.
As well as what Holy Master told me, yes, the winner of this will play against Darrer. Darrer dropped down to the very, very bottom of round 1.5, and they will play up against the winner of this game. TE versus Darrer, PB versus Darrer. Both options I can accept. And we'll be happy to see. So now I got it for our ban hours. PB, they're moving out of CK, so they're looking at the at the focus firing down of Morphling again. So banning him out again. Empires is, I think it's like the third time now they banned Beastmaster in that fourth ban slot.
Yeah, sneaking plays actually a really, really good Beastmaster on the offlane. Especially on the Dire side when it's just so easy to stack up those Ancients. Mm-hmm. It makes sense for Empire to take it out just to prevent that sort of easy option for Pot and Bottom. So that just making them think a little bit harder about their draft. I know Sneaking also likes to play the Brewmaster, but not in the offlane role. 10 seconds remaining.
Sorry, I just got messaged something very, very funny. I gotta stop reading that kind of stuff when we're trying to do a match.
doing a match. There's a draft going on, and you're just looking at pictures of cats.
Man, pictures of cats should never be underestimated. Cats are cool. Cats
are
cool.
I agree.
They're as cool as dogs. I'm a person that sits on both sides of that fence. I'm all about having the cats play with the dogs. It doesn't have to be wars, man. It's like Trekkies and Star Wars fans. You don't have to be at war. Everyone's equal.
I think they'd opt to disagree.
Why do I think I have a Trekkie fan sitting here? Am I
right? I watch Star Wars because I think the acting is comedical and sort of funny. And
if you're about to say the acting was really, really good and the screen and like the script writing was amazing, I was about to disconnect you from this call.
That is not what I believe.
I watch Star Wars because it reminds me of the Shakespearean actors from West End.
Windrunner, yes. At your service.
Yes, that's exactly the reason. Radiant, and that'll be bullshit. If anybody likes the acting in Star Wars, they have to like seek therapy. The only really good thing, actually, no. Even a great actor like Natalie Portman and Ewan McGregor both get completely destroyed by the script.
I don't even consider those Star Wars movies.
Oh, you're meaning 4, 5, and 6?
Yeah, 4, 5, and 6. The acting is like a little, like it, the lines are a little strange.
You gotta be careful about the original trilogy, man.
I get a lot of haters, but
man, you like knocking on 1, 2, and 3. That's fine. Like Jar Jar Binks, cute, totally toy flip. Yeah, no. But if you start like, sure, Empire defeated by Ewoks, not as realistic. lame lines, corny. Yeah, kind of good. Anyway, let's get off this, man, or else we could be here for a very, very long time.
And we're just everybody's gonna hate us because we're gonna say something that offends everybody.
No, that's already done, man. You already started abusing on any small points of episode 4, 5, and 6. Let's jump in. Why do we start off on Stargate? But our final ban is now done. So Titan to be banned out by Empire. They had the last ban. That was after Broodmother got banned out as well. So Aoi, in fact, one of his favorite heroes is being removed off, but he's already got the Morphling, so he doesn't really care right now. Windrunner's also up, so PB goes still a lot to work with for that one. And Empire, they continue to stack up their team fight potential. So we've got Scream, we've got Ulti through the Sonic Wave. If they catch out any good combo right now from Empire, then PB are royally screwed. But when that happens, what do you grab, Han? If you want to find one hero that can throw a spanner in the works, or at least a kegger, who would you grab up to destroy an entire team fight?
You'd grab a Brewmaster.
That you would! That you would! Top of the class for Ham. Top of the class for Ham. And Brewmaster is a pain in the drunken proverbial ass. And Empire now got with Lone Druid as their final pickup. And that's their Tower Melter. They're looking to win this early. If this goes past 40 minutes, they're in a lot of trouble.
But at the same time, Aoi's looking, or not Aoi, Pot and Bottom is looking to delay it for as long as possible so Aoi can get that Morphling up to the point where they can just like right-click down the entirety of Empire. And Empire doesn't have that much HP. I mean, Lone Druid has a lot when he's in bear form. But as far as Leshrac, Queen of Pain, Enigma goes, they don't really have that much health.
Mm-hmm. You're all right, man. Like, survival, that's the reason why we see BKBs come up from both those heroes. It's the only way you can survive. Well, then again, BKB for Enigma is more along the lines of, I just don't wish to be interrupted. But even actually, is there anything for PB that goes through that? I don't think there is.
Nope.
Again, and again, another free black hole. We saw it in our last game. The only downside is they never managed to pick one properly. In fact, how many black holes do you remember? I remember seeing it on cooldown once. And that's all I remember.
I don't remember you blasting out my eardrums.
Thanks. Obviously, that's a good indication. Let's watch PB, blast away, always want to fly. Nope, he saw him early enough. And there's not enough movement speed to catch up right now. And then instantly we see Jackal hiding inside the tree. So let's run through very, very quickly because PB aren't going to get this kill anymore. Jackal, he'll be down here hiding inside the trees, going into the role as Lashrak on the bottom lane. Always want to fly, supporting him as the Sand King down there on the bottom lane as well. So very, very strong lane for them. Always, anything that couples up with Lashrak is great. Queen of Pain will be the middle lane solo. Scandal taking up that role. Blow Your Brain, top lane solo lone druid. Already be scouting out the rune. Then we'll be pulling down the creep wave in a couple of moments' time. And Nima will take one creep from the top lane. That is J4. And then he'll go into the jungle, where we already see PB. Is that Yuz? What?
US East.
Oh, okay. That's what he's asking about. I'm like, Yuz? Like, well, that's with a W, and why are we talking about farm animals. Sneaking, he'll be our brewmaster down the bottom lane. Always love watching his brew. And he'll be joined by Tides of Time. This time around, a Windrunner in a sort of support role. Look, it's a trap! You cannot repel Kegger of that magnitude. Always want to fly on the run. One power shot, lines are up, not enough damage. Not 70 HP. Enough. It's only a level 1 power shot.
I thought he was going to skill Shackle Shot there and just latch him, try and latch him to the forest there.
I think they realized they need a little bit more damage to bring him down. If you get the Shackle up, Brewmaster might get, what, one right click, two right clicks? But equal that to a Power Shot damage, which you got at 120.
Well, it's only 90 damage because of the magic resist, so it's close.
Noting too, like, we just go for a pause and then the middle lane, Fog just running around from Scandal. I don't know about this, man. Scandal's looking pretty brutal. That dagger just up in the air. I don't know what Fog is doing with his arms. Just like, I need to summon my magics. What did he end up going as well? We got Triple Exort. He's already been Poison Stinged. Or Striked. Shadow Striked. We'll get to the real name eventually.
Yeah.
Let's go League of Legends style. Well, he's already been queued. But don't worry. He'll QWE, then he'll R, then D, and then T.
T is only a skill if you're using the courier.
I have my own hotkeys.
I do too. I use Legacy.
T's just another like easy jump over for those extra abilities. I always just find it easy to use T for my hotkeys. It's like all those people, if you, I could always tell, like, where you came from when you're a first-person shooter gamer. If you were a Battlefield guy, or a Call of Duty guy, or a Counter-Strike guy, just to see where your sprint button was, your slow movement button was, and your melee was. For anybody who ever uses shift as a melee button, hello to those Battlefield fans out there. Really?
Yes.
He actually uses what?
Yes. I don't know why. I honestly don't know why.
Well, I suppose each man to his own.
I mean, he does have, like, giant hands, so maybe it's just the way his paw sits on the keyboard makes it easier. I have no idea.
Does he really throw, like, a paw on a keyboard?
He's going to message me telling me that I'm retarded for using Legacy, though, so I'm waiting for that in 2 minutes.
Mm-hmm. Man, hang on, what, you use Legacy keys?
Yeah, I use Legacy. Are you going to tell me I'm retarded now?
I would never say that on a live stream. I'll tell you that afterwards.
All right.
Cool, awesome, fantastic. So we're going to pause here. We just lost Shadow Demon for no apparent reason, apart from maybe his computer just crashed. So he's currently walking off that top lane. Might have also screwed him a little bit here with the timing, because Shadow Demon's already making his movement back, and he would have been down for the perfect double pull. So the double pull for pot and bottom's not going to happen for him. Not for this top lane, at least. Not yet.
Not yet. And our bottom lane's looking sort of even as well. Sand King did use up that heal, though. So I think bottom lane's ahead in terms of consumables. Mm-hmm. But it's all going to be about the ability for Empire to combo up Burrowstrike plus Split Earth.
It's difficult, man. Like, always when a fly wants to jump in there, he's instantly going to get stomped.
Yeah, that's the problem with Sand King, is you're basically putting yourself right in stomp range just to stun the Brewmaster.
The only upside you can really have is if he catches up both of them, like right now the Tides and Sneaking are standing right next to each other, and then you have Lashrak chain off their stun. Always want to fly, won't take that harassment, and could probably dish out a decent amount himself before Sneaking and Tides come back out again. But if Windrun pops off, and Brewmaster's already pretty fat, and then you add him a Stout Shield, he's got a lot to defend with. So the amount of damage that can come out from Empire is not going to be that amazing.
No, especially not a level 1.
Mm-hmm. They need the extra levels, and it's going to mean Edict from Jackal, but that also means catching out PB away from the creep wave. And Brewmaster as well as Windrunner, it's not going to be easy when you're in that kind of position, because then you know there's going to be trees around there, and by the time you hit level 2,
nope.
Tai should be level
there
2
it is.
As well.
I got the message. I'm retarded for using Legacy.
You knew it was coming, man.
I knew it was coming.
You just had to wait that 2 minutes before it caught up on the live stream. What is this? ZXCV? Someone uses ZXCV. Mustn't like moving his palm of his hand further up the keyboard. All that fun kind of stuff.
I use ZXC when I'm playing Shadow Fiend.
Why?
Because those are Shadow Raises. ZXCR, Legacy.
Oh, man. I know originally I thought about using Legacy Keys just on Puck because I was so used to it. I was so used to it on Puck. And then I finally got my brain to rework it around, and I modified a couple of the keys that worked a little bit better for me. It was like all these guys out there who always want to use like War Keys back in the Warcraft 3 days. Oh, looks like we might have ourselves a bit of a remake.
Yeah, we might have to.
If you can't get back into the game. But yeah, this guy's like, they're always asking for War Keys. War Keys was... I think War Keys is one of the biggest delays we ever really had when it came to like LAN events for Warcraft 3 Dota. Remember the amount of time, like the delay reducer and War Keys. They were the biggest issues to get past when we're doing LAN events for Warcraft 3. You always try and work with it, and sometimes something will always just break on you. Like LAN events do. Like LAN events always do. There's our reconnect back in again.
That's why we say we'll just wait a bit.
Yeah. It's a Christmas miracle. All right, so we're good to go.
Oh, we're not quite good to go.
Someone went to the toilet. Wait, lol, what? Do we pause again instantly? No, we don't. And now, come on, will he get the pull? Will he get the pull? He goes off to the side.
Oh, he does.
Way too sexy, is way too fast. And he's going to go for the secondary pull up.
Oh, Tides of Time.
You know what? I'm watching him do his pull, and now it's just not going to work. Jackal, he's on really low life. Sneaking, trying to catch up him for one last hit. Burrow Strike. Is there a follow-up? Lashrak's done. Oh, man, there could have been. And that could have been Sneaking's life as well. 1-0 now. And I blame the Pulse missing first blood. Shifting blame from myself.
Especially because we just talked about it and said, oh, no, they don't have enough damage to get first blood. No problems here.
Obviously, our calculations were wrong. And then Scandal and Fog get to go head-to-head here in the middle lane. Scandal's committing to this one. He's still got Blink away if he needs to. And he's going to hope that Sting. Nice, son! Strike! Scandal.
That was so close.
Too fleet underfoot, man. Too fleet underfoot. And Munter's on his tangos. How many consumables are left for these guys? They've both got, like, one set of tangos left. Well, he's got two charges left and his tango's fogged, and Scandal's got one. And now they're going to look for the two-minute rune, which isn't top. It is, in fact, bottom, and it's a regen, so it's exactly what Scandal needs. And he's just, he's short of having his mana for it, and here's the rotation out from Jackal. He'll find the regen, and he'll just swipe it.
Yeah, Lestrak needed the regen as well. All these fights early, and that saves a lot of bottom lane's consumables. Sand King's out, but it means that Lestrak still has the four tangos to go around.
Mm-hmm. And they look at Sneaky, he's got five tangos on his down shield, but that's because Tides of Time still got it's a full set of tangos. I'm hearing Sunstrike again. Is that going middle lane yet? Scandal again. Getting stunned up. Cole snapped. He's going to go down here. Fogdale to bring him down, and he calls the well played out.
And Fogged is a great invoker player, and he has great insight to what players are going to do. So when you're playing up against a hero like Queen of Pain, you have to anticipate the blink and Sunstrike accordingly. And he just does it so well.
Mm-hmm. I'm guessing he screwed something up here. All right, so Tides of Time, he's looking at J4, and they can combo again. If they want to, they can do that Sunstrike with a Shackle and Power Shot, and that Sunstrike should be a decent level up now. What we got? Well, it's actually only 2 points into the Exort. I'm hearing Sting going again here in the middle lane, and Fog, look at him just rocking down Scandal. Scream won't be enough. Cole Snap blinks himself away, goes instant bottle charges, realizing he's really low on life. I needed that back again, but then comes Tides of Time. Looking for Scandal. He's already damaged him down enough. A level 1 Power Shot's not going to be enough to kill him off. He's still going to try. But Scandal's already popped his bottle charge. Now turns around. Stings. And on one scream, it's going to bring Tires down pretty low. But has forced Scandal to use up every single bit of his mana. And now he's blinked for the room. No, Tides of Time. He'll run up there. Illusion. Pick up the illusion. In comes Scandal again. He has one scream away from a kill. Tides will tick. No, he won't. The tangos will keep him up there, and Scandal, man, he came so close to death there. The timing for his blink to get away.
The attack was in the air.
Attack is in the air. Every time Cup goes for room. Oh my god, why am I... No, moving on. I just broke one of the rules of casting.
Started singing?
Yep. It's a big rule for casting.
I recall that you've broken that rule once before. I guess not usually during a game.
No. You do it outside of games. Outside of games is okay. That's within the breaking of rules agreement. Yeah, it's just like you never cast drunk, you never sing during the stream. And you're good.
Ooh. Might have broken a rule once or twice with you.
Oh! Shame! I shall never forgive you. Never.
A lot of harass coming on top lane. Awesome. Now he's doing a great job keeping Blow Your Brain at least back a little bit.
It's also just, oh man, goodbye. Sunstrike, catcher, combo, and Owie just stands there watching.
And he didn't even do anything, he just walked up and...
Mm-hmm. But now Scandal's trying to get one Fog. Fog's looking for a doubler. He's out of mana, Reverend. Scandal knows this, so he keeps going with a scream. Sting will be off cooldown in a couple of moments' time, but Fog's Reichly, that's a lot of damage. Scandal, bottle charge, perfect timing out from Scandal. And then on bottom lane, we're watching Sneaking go back there, and there's the call out. Damn that bottle, Tides of Time, Reichly will disjoin after the blink. I would hate his bottle as well. Oh man, J4, found Sneaking. He's thinking about it. He should really pop the black hole right now. Catching a Sneaking Jackal. He's thinking about just landing that stun. Now SK's going to come in. Nice Sunstrike. Keeps that extra damage and needs to be split around the rest of the team.
Doesn't need the black hole. But as I've said before, popping off black hole 6 minutes on one hero, not a big deal.
It's worth it. It's worth it. Queen of Pain looking at Fogged again. And Invoker gets a regen, switches to Quas, nice Cole Snap, Fog Fine from the high ground as well. Scandal knew he didn't have the advantage. So backed himself out again. And then on the top lane, always want to fly. Able to escape out of that one as well. No Shackle still on Windrunner, but she's only level 3. The experience per minute for Windrunner is 90 experience per minute. Lone Druid's getting more than her on this top lane, and Blow Your Brain has got nothing, like absolutely no- Sorry, he has a ring of regen back in his stash, and two tangos.
He doesn't even have his bear up yet.
Not
from
five,
when he died.
5 seconds and he can recreate his bear. But he is the poorest thing. I'm waiting for the Sunstriker, the Invoker to Sunstrike. And there's the Quas Chain. Oh, he can't make up his mind. I think he's just keeping his fingers nimble, going from Quas to Exort, Quas to Exort. In this case, now back at base.
Well, one level and I'll be able to have both spells, so that makes sense.
Oh, we're going looking at mid. No Shackle. And now our top lane, in fact, is going to come in. So this will be where the Exort will come into play. Watch for the switch. Morphling. Yep, there's our waveform. Blow Your Brain. Catch it up. Owie needs one last right click, and he's going to use the replica to jump in a little bit closer. No, he doesn't. He does the old-fashioned way, and now always want to fly. Tried to shed there on the Brewmaster, who turns around with his ultimate form. Now beating down on J4. They pop the smoke, so they cannot fight him. Jackal, however, says, I don't care for no smoke. And gets himself back out of it again. But making the most of these last little Brewlings on the front lines. And sneaking, that level 6, you gotta look for it, man. Upset to try man gank.
Yeah, but at the same time, Empire has the smoke ready to make sure that Brewmaster can't turn it around. So, even if they bait out the Brewmaster ulti, they know he doesn't have it, at least not for a while.
Yeah, now they can push down the towers. Fortification forced out by both teams, in fact. Owie as well as Way Too Sexy pushing out the top lane. And we've got double lane support, or double hero support this bottom lane.
Oh,
nice Burrow Strike going
to
the epicenter. And there's no Shackle to stop it. So Sneaky will take a fall. Lone Druid goes down the top lane in the meantime. Now the Black Hole for one hero. Get out of there, Enigma! Get out of there! You cannot tank towers! Aggro was taken by Jackal at just the last moment. And they'll TP back out to safety. But man, Empire living life on the edge.
Yeah, Enigma. Doing just the right amount of black hole, just the right amount of tower tank, and
now we go middle lane. Burrow Strike and Scream. Easy setup, nice rotation by Empire, and Tides of Time comes in. Lets off the power shot, does do a little bit of damage, but it's only a level 2, and he has a level in Shackle now, finally. But he really can't do much with it. The support coming in, Shadow Demon's making its move, but always on a fly, is moving back very, very fast. Gotta love those arcanes with the movement speed, plus 65 for him on that.
Now, this is a great start for the Sand King, not dying, which means that he can put all his money into those key items. He's already got the arcanes, as you said, and well on his way to Blink.
Hey, he'll be feeling pretty good about himself. What is our... I don't know why I'm even using that menu anymore. I'm like bringing up menus, which I don't really need to use. TP support's Scandal, look in that middle lane. He wants a Lashrak. He wants a Lashrak stun. He's got ultimate right now. He's got more than enough mana for the full combo. And 10 minute rune, what was it? Sneaking? Yeah, he picked up a double damage rune and rotating mid. And the ward from the dice looking for this. They can see him up there. They just cannot get close enough to him to initiate. There's no blink dagger up on the Brewmaster. There's no instant four staff out. You can Sunstrike, but that's still going to mean Shadow Demon needs to get in position for a disruption and as well as catcher.
And Sneaking's forced to rotate back down because nothing's happening on mid lane. You can't give away a free lane worth of farm and experience for that long and get nothing done.
Mm-hmm. Obviously also Blow Your Brain using his bear to tank up the Thunder Lizards. Also realizing too that bear is dying very, very fast. I can only kill off the big one and that was it. I'm hearing disruption right now as well as a quad body. Is Invoker? Yeah, it's Invoker. Trying to bring him down middle lane. Nicely done here with the Sunstrike just against Scandal. He's going to keep diving and gets the last Scream off. Man, Fogged and Scandal.
Just trading kills in the mid lane. They've been having a good battle.
Even the smack talk in the middle of the battles is like, yes, sup, I hate your bottle. It's kind of like something you see over a kindergarten playground. My bottle, your bottle, my bottle, blow your brain dead. Oh, wait, 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 Owie's not going to go for that. I think he realized he can get blocked in there and blow your brain. On 44 life points, walks away from a Morphling. And then on bottom lane, we see SK, he's a long way up there. Am I hearing it? That was a Sunstrike searching for Blow Your Brain just then. Dire's bottom tower. I heard that in the back of my ears, and Invoker was doing it. Yeah, still on cooldown again. But bottom lane tier 1 tower goes down. Scandal and Fogged. Cold Snap now going out in Scandal. Another 10 seconds before he can try that Sunstrike and blow your brain. He's getting light back up again. Now Burrow Strike. Going to see if he can get it on Tides of Time, but Tides of Time very, very fast underfoot. He rotates up through the jungle, so Tides of Time went the long way around to the level 4. Burrow Strike has a long, long range. Follow up the stun by Jackal. Now the Black Call catching up Fogged. Oh, way too sexy. He was not caught out in that one. So he does just a disruption off. And there goes the Lashrak into the epicenter from Always When a Fly. He's going to get some good damage right now on Fogged as well as sneaking. But he's got to be too close towards that tower. Goes up the Sandstorm, avoids the last hit out there. So Scandal can finish off first Fogged. And now looking towards sneaking. It's already stung up. So one blink to scream. He's got this kill. But it means he'll have to come in range of that tower. And sneaking knows it. He's going to look for that clap. But then again, he doesn't have mana for that either. So Scandal, we'll let it go. Why do I keep on saying sneaking? Ah, it's because he's Brewmaster. That's the reason why.
Because he's in this game.
Lol. But Empire will do the same thing. They'll push out the T1 in mid.
Yeah, they came out on top of that fighter, enough on top that they can get their tower. Dire's middle tower has fallen. And now Leshrac can happily rotate to another lane, take out the last tier 1, or even continue pushing on bottom and mid.
Mm-hmm. What is he buying right now?
Starcanes.
Oh, I'm clicked on the wrong person. I really gotta stop doing that. I was clicked on. What was it? It wasn't even Nemo. I think it was. No. I have no idea what I was clicked on. Who's got just boots? Windrunner. I was clicked on Windrunner saying she doesn't have enough money for arcane, so I don't know why he's walking in there. No, wait, that's someone else. Welcome to the mental hour. Can't believe we're hitting that already. It's early in the night, man. It's really early in the night for that. Scandal, blink up, starts with a sting, just trying to slow Aoi down. He's still got ulti up, you see, if he wants to, but he wants always want to fly to get this stun off so he doesn't have to. One blink to scream, and he can block him out again. There's the blink, and oh, nice waveform. At the same time, Ulti will fly up by Quap, but it's not enough damage. Aoi was strength mopping through it all, and now the stun's flying up. Brewmaster with a clap, and Scandal got himself blocked up there right now, so he cannot help out. Jackal is shackled up, gets Sunstrike down. J4 is doing what it can. Scandal still doesn't mean to pop himself back out of here just yet, but when he does do so, way too sexy will take a fall, and now he does do so. The Brewling sending the Enigma up in towards the air. He's got nothing really to pop off apart from the stun there on the Windrunner, trying to buy some time for Scandal, but the shackle from Tides of Time locks Scandal towards a tree. He tries to blink away, but falls on his haunches. And now Fogged chasing down J4, retreating out through the top lane. And he'll get away pretty safely. And all of this is still buying time for Blow Your Brain to catch up on this farm, which he's been missing out on.
Yeah, but at the same time, Aoi's didn't die and has free farm in bottom. So it's going to be sort of a race to see who can get key items up first between the Lone Druid and the Morphling, while everybody else sort of defends towers and fights.
Mm-hmm. It's just a dangerous, dangerous world to try and fight in right now for Empire, unless they get that combo right. And if they don't, you see what happened on top lane. PB, just pick them off. Split them up.
They invested a ton into that Morphling kill. I don't even think it would have been worth it had they killed the Morphling.
Yeah.
Well, they just lost so much.
Mm-hmm. Aoi being forced back here on the bottom lane. Always on fire, being very, very aggressive there. And Aoi must have been thinking maybe there's a little bit more to this than meets the eye. But there's not. The support's coming up on the top lane. It's Leshrac as well as J4. Looking to push down this tier 1 tower. Sneaking. Still with no blink taker just yet, but he's got enough support. Especially with the TP now coming in from Aoi.
Oh, he's going to cut off Jackal here.
Yep, there goes the Drunken Haze. TP will go out from our Enigma. Sunstrike will go, and Jackal looking to TP out as well, but he won't get out there in time. Shadow Demon even, I believe, casting Purge out for that little sucker, just to ensure the kill. But they're pulling people off lanes, and this is something which Pot and Bottom did really well in the last game. It's what let them win the game. But it hurts them if they don't get these kills. The upside for them is they keep on getting these kills. But the downside is, if they don't, if that top lane happened, the Morphling TP's up their support, Leshrac and Enigma both get away, then it nails you so badly. Like, you've lost lane control in the bottom lane, SK's gonna get his farm, that's boosting up towards his Blink Dagger as well. So when he hits that, he's gonna be laughing all the way at the bank. And then
Scandal,
Queen of Pain,
being careful in mid lane.
Man, he's gonna blink, he doesn't have it. Oh! Stands the ground against Invoker. Bottle charge, he's gone back in again. He does not end on one kill. That's why you even see Stick Charge popping up there by Way Too Sexy. Mech Charge from J4. Burrow Strike trying to catch him out. Disruption. And Scale's just like, sweet. You want to stick around? No, no, you don't. Okay. Really smart play there by Scandal. Knew he had enough damage to kill him off. And having that double damage rune to set it up really helps out too. And this means now that Empire can take yet again another positional. Another tower to go down.
I think that's the difference between game one and... game two and game three.
Oh, Scandal! Trouble!
Oh, Scandal got shackled.
Wonderful shackle again by Tides of Time. And very, very fast on that Invoker Sunstrike by Fogged. He was just walking out of base, he was watching that fight very, very closely, and that Sunstrike started almost instantly after Shackle latched.
Yeah, this Invoker's just been on the mark all day.
That's why I love watching Fogged play it, man. Pot and bottom, they're one of these teams that they've got some real good superstar players in their lineup. They just need to chain off a couple more successes. And maybe finally get themselves a sponsor.
Yeah, I think getting a sponsor will help, and along with practicing as a team a little bit more. Getting to know your friends, getting to know who's reliable for what, and just practicing your strategies in and out.
It is always that fun thing. When do you get time to practice as a team, and what teams really have focus enough to do it? Oh, always on a flight. Nice time for him to have a Blink Dagger. He is, however, perched up using Sandstorm, trying to bait, and then Burrow straight through. Wait, he's caught inside the trees. They can see him in there. Or can they? Shadow Poison not on him, it's just the perch. They don't have the vision of him, and now J4's going to take a fall. And Brewmaster, Aldi will split. Sandstorm starts off from Ascan. It's like, wait, I think he's still here. Burrow strikes through, looking for Shadow Demon. It's almost enough, but he's losing a lot of life now. The Broomlings will send him up in towards the air. I think that was an entangle for a very, very short amount of time. Forge Spirits just trying to prep themselves. Always want to fly though, a lot of life regen happened in the meantime. And Scandal looking for sneaking, and what a time for him to get back into that form. Oh, nice Shackle holding Blow Your Brain as well as Scandal out. Sunstrike trying to help off the kill off, always want to fly, it might even work too if that entangle didn't latch just then. So Brewmaster takes a fall, and in the meantime, Aoi pushing out the tier 2 tower on top lane.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Yeah, Empire could have done a lot more with that fight, I think. They had Enigma Black Hole, but at the same time,
nice.
Enigma denies the tower.
He's going to lose his life for it, though. The replicant's already there, so Aoi can jump if he wants to, but no, he decides not to in the end. I think he thought the Malifaux stun would make it so easy for him to do so, but it triggered the Linkage in the end. It had no effect. Scandal, 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 Scandal. Looking for Tides. Quapalti! One more scream! One more scream! Shackle won't lash! He needs a right click! He's gonna find it too, and then blink! Tower hits! Whoa! 11! And the timing! He TPs before walking in, so the stun strike doesn't hit! Couldn't predict that one!
That's playing it on the edge.
Scandal being elusive. Wondering what. Well, it looks like he's building towards BKB as well. He's getting sick of being harassed and locked down. No call snaps to stop him from having his fun.
Dire's top tower.
Top
has
lane
fallen.
Going down to Enigma. Bottom tower
is under attack. And there's that Mythical Hammer by Scandal. Yeah, he's building towards it. Now finds a regen rune as well. But they lose the bottom tower. Looks like Sneaking was down there as well, having some fun. Scandal's going to find him. He can do as much harassment as he wants to. While he's got that regen rune, doesn't really have to fear too much. Maybe dying, but apart from that, it's okay. He can take a lot of damage. As long as he doesn't overcommit, he's fine. Blink yourself into a jungle. Regen up. Come back out again. And then kill.
Yeah, that's the power of regen rune on heroes that can get in and out.
We got prep.
So you need this. Oh, Empire. Always want to fly here. Is just waiting for that perfect.
It's because J4.
Oh, there it goes.
J4's got the black. Oh no! Oh no! 2,000 now. He's gonna have a great time. The support comes in by Shadow Demon, purging up here on Enigma. He's gonna try and TP himself back out. Disruption goes on the opposition. So now they can go and always want to fly as well. It is an absolute disaster. Burrow striking away. It looks like always when a flyer is going to be able to juke this one out. Or maybe not. Tide's coming in. The Shackle won't latch. Can mini stun for a moment if he wants to. And no. I'm not gonna go. He can't even use his arcanes right now. Always wanna fly, doesn't even have mana to pop the arcanes. Sneaking coming in. Always wanna fly, still try and juke this out. Now I can use arcanes, but 10 seconds cooldown. Into the sandstorm, try and juke him around the side. Voice of power shot, shackle as well. Man, this is going on forever while Invoker goes down to the Queen of Pain. Where is he going? Where is he going? Man, that tower! It's gonna...
just going anywhere that isn't Windrunner. By dying to a tower, you do deny yourself. Well, if you get far enough away and then die to a tower, you at least deny yourself the experience given to the other team.
That's true. They didn't, though. Scandal. Double damage rune again. He's already prepping for the middle lane. No tier 2 tower as well. Look at that right-click damage. Morbid's going to come in. And will it be enough to tick him? No, it won't. Majestic charges will be there. And Scandal stays at ground on the higher ground. And, well, maybe probably should have done that. Sneaking's already there. Now he's going to blink. And TP instantly. Will get himself out to safety and picks his BKB up back at base. Also notice too, blow your brain will now have that relic. It's going to look up towards the shop and buy it. And there we go. Bear comes back. So it's a little bit of a later radiance than what we'd normally expect out from a lone druid, but for a side lane druid, I wouldn't say it's too bad.
And he has gotten the phase boots on his bear and the tranquil boots on his hero before he started saving for his radiance. So, I mean, it's not like it's naked. Mm-hmm. Naked relic.
Yeah. PB, you had to claim off Roshan again. Roshan has fallen to the I say again. I kind of feel like the last game we saw so many Roshans, it wasn't funny. Three.
Yeah, it was always pot and bottom claiming the Roshans, it seemed. They just seem to do it... like, a lot of teams wait until there's a gank or a tower falls and they get Roshan on the retreat. But pot and bottom seems to just sort of muscle up and take out Roshan when they know that they're at just a slight advantage.
Right, so we've got a problem right now with Empire. Just one of the boys are lagging up. So just asking for just a moment there for the connection to stabilize. So they can keep on playing through. Just checking out our last isn't nice with this wonderful screen which we can do on the side. It doesn't have to block anything. 169 for 16. So big on that Morphling, man. No one is near him. No one is near Aoi. He's going to have a Lincoln Sphere Treads as well as a Ghost Scepter. Thought he would have had a little bit more than that, though. Like, what's his gold per minute is 442, which is pretty decent, but Scandal is still staying pretty damn close, 388. And Scandal's experience per minute tops that of Morphlings.
Scandal's got four kills, has been in, and a ton of assists. Well, not a ton. She's got three assists. So just getting that experience from being in fights, whereas Morphling's sort of been side-laned. Oh, we got an Epicenter mid lane here.
Yeah, that was a little bit of fun. That was SK trying to do what he could, but he already lost his teammate now, and Nima's going to come in.
Coming.
Nice black hole, catching out the four. Aoi, he's having a lot of damage there from the tower. TP support, though, is way too late. It's a black hole with no follow-through until Jackal arrives and goes, sup! Maybe ties of time. Needs a stun, the pulse is already going. Scandal, blink again in 3 seconds' time, and ties. Blink up by J4, misses him. And didn't have mana for a stun as well. There goes the Sting, and Tides will take a fall. So, two now going down for Empire, and one down for Pot and Bottom.
Way too sexy. He's just hoping not to run into Queen of Pain.
He's got no TP.
He's just hoping that nobody walks near him.
He's lucky, too. There's no vision around this area. He's actually hanging around for this middle lane. They want to go here on J4. And there's a push in. Goes with a catcher. Disrupts himself just in case someone's going to come in and kill him. And believe me, always want to fly. He's definitely thinking about it. But he stands up and sneaking anyway, forcing him to take damage from the tower. And forcing them back. Really surprised he didn't try and go there for way too sexy.
We decided this is sort of an interesting position for Empire. Because they haven't met, like, that black hole was great. The problem was the entire team was dead before it happened. So they're gonna have to make sure to get these abilities comboed off in the right order. They need to initiate with the Enigma. And he's got a blink, so he should be able to do that. They need to wait for the black hole and then get a good epicenter. Or use the epicenter as a distraction just to blink on the enemy team and get that black hole. It was just a little bit too late. Everybody had already taking the fall.
Now we sit ourselves in this position where we still look and go, well, PB, they're now 3K worth of experience in front, which is basically nothing. And Empire are 2.5K gold in front, which is basically nothing. But the biggest thing for Empire right now is the fact they've taken out every single outer tier 1 tower. They've removed out 2 tier 2s. And that top tier 2, well, actually hasn't been touched at all on the top lane. But Empire, as far as their position goes, and their possibility after they win a teamfight to push in to take a Rax, it is a lot higher than what PB is capable of achieving. And they're going to try and push into this middle lane, and do we have that? Well, Black Hole is down for another 50 seconds. It's not now ever going to stop our wonderful Queen of Pain from jumping in there, and well, we're going to think about it again. BKB is up. There goes the Scream. Still got ulti up asleep, but she's trying to save it right now. Now she'll pop it on Shadow Demon Disruption, but a little bit too late. Scannel blinks herself away. Brewmaster has also popped off his ultimate, looking for J4, gets a stun out in him. Lashrak looking to also follow up with his stuns, but not going to work off. We've got SK currently up in a twist. Comes back down to the Sandstorm. And the push down the middle lane again starts. Right, really can't go much further. We've now got the Bear with the Radiance towards the front lines. Looking for an entangle on that, and already just hear that Bear just growl it up. Looking for a right click, trying to use the Forge Spirits to block him off. Meanwhile, in the middle lane, always want to fly in. J4 really locked together with a nice Shackle Shot by Tides of Time. And now the Sting, Sunstrike. Just a little bit off target, but it's going to be way too sexy. Going to go down. Sneaky tries to jump in from behind, looking for a stun. And now I saw a jump in there by Aoi. Just shotties down the low strike. Not even a shotty, that was just normal. That was just an adaptive strike coming out from him. And Sneaking, man, that Bear damage is not going to be enough to kill him off. Oh! Really, really close. 13 HP went down to him. They managed to snipe off the Bear. And Blow Your Brain cannot recreate that for a while. Another minute before he can have that Bear back again.
Yeah. I don't think the Bear yet had the Radiance.
Yes, it did.
Oh, it did?
Yeah, it had the Radiance when they first started pursuing
down.
Oh,
yeah, you're right, it did. I did see that glow on it. So they're without the Radiance for a while.
Mm-hmm. And PB, now we see the shotty up on Aoi. He didn't have that before the last fight, and now he's got it. So how much life points do we start looking through? SK, he's got a decent amount. He's got the coin booster, Lashrak point booster, and Vitality booster. Enigma, Mech,
and more. Enigma's going to be close if you had a waveform on top of the shotgun combo.
Mm-hmm. Queen of Pain, here we go again. BKB, starting off with a Scream. No Sonic Wave this time around. An Epicenter hitting pretty nicely there by the SK. Black Cold chain it off there. Deafening Blast, however, will push them back out. So J4 being interrupted there. And Sneaking, really low life. He's got no ultimate, so they will bring him down. Finally, he does take a fall. And the pop happens as well. The Brewmaster comes back up again, but Lashrak and Queen of Pain already now down the sidelines. J4 also brought down, so three players lost for Empire. And bottom, gonna look to push down this middle lane, but while this is all happening, Blow Your Brains up on the top lane. Recreates his Bear, balls to do so. But he knows he must push down this tower. He's got to force the trade out by PP. And the TP might go back to base. Well, it is one, it's Aoi he's returning to that. But he's healing up before he goes again, and Blow Your Brain doesn't have to stop right now. He can keep pushing. PB, they want to do the same. Yeah. Down the middle lane.
You want to get some damage on this tier 3 here. Well, they have an opportunity.
Well, your brain has no TP. He's got no money for a TP scroll, man. He's got to sell
that
something.
That is a mistake. He's going to have to sell his Quelling Blade.
It's because he just bought Vlad's. He just bought Vlad's. Fallen. And he's returning with the Vlad's down towards that middle lane, but the barracks is already
that's
gone.
That's a barracks.
PB pushed fast, and they can go for another one, too. It's a long way out, and this is not where Lone Druid wants to walk back in through. Even the Courier's in the wrong position right now. And the Bear towards the front lines, that Bear has... Well, remember the cooldown time for that one. Nice, Burrow from Always. Catching out three, then Morphling waves in. Nice blink in by Sneaking. Gets a stomp off, picking up the Lashrak. Now J4, there is nothing he can do about this. No Black Hole from him. Aoi, he's got 2 seconds left in that wave. Uses the Adaptive Strike instead. And, well, here we go. Morphling waves out, looking for Scandal. And he's going to find him. Scandal forced to blink himself away. SK again sent up in towards the air by these Storm Broodlings. And Lone Druid wants to come back towards the front lines, but is that Bear down again? This is the top racks. This should be top racks. There is nothing that's there, and there's just...
Oh, there goes Sand King.
Yep, Aoi might be brought down right now here by a Scandal, but he can strength warp himself up. He's going to TP out, and he already made a replica of Queen of Pain. They'll be back in a moment. And bottom can keep this going. They don't need to fall back right now. They might be thinking it because of Scandal and Morphling's not 100% there with them. He's back at base, he's trying to regen up slowly. But they shouldn't stick out for too long. There's a Queen of Pain replicate already harassing on Scandal. Lawyer Brain can now resummon his bear as well, but he's also... Yep, there we go. Bear's back up again.
Oh, there goes Queen of Pain.
That hardly hurt at all.
And the bear... That's the power of the replicate, not just being a surprise.
Mm-hmm. And now watch this bear go down again. They strike it and destroy it. And you can't keep this...
He needs to put the items on his hero.
Yep.
Oh, and there's the GG.
That's GG, well played.
Matter.
So Empire, their run here in the defense will end. And Pot and Bottom will continue. And in fact, it's going to continue very, very shortly. Pot and Bottom will be going up against Virtus Pro. It'll be the Game 3 of the semi-final from the Fnatic RC Cup. We'll be broadcasting it out from here as well. So if you're thinking about going anywhere, well, you can do so. I'm not really going to stop you. But if you want to watch the game of Pot and Bottom versus Virtus Pro, stick around. We shall be returning with that game very, very shortly.
I said good day, sir!